Hello again, everyone. Welcome back. Well, today we're going to start a four-part series on one of the new cigars from Dunbarton Tobacco and Trust, the Stillwell Star. Now, the interesting thing about the Stillwell Star is it incorporates pipe tobacco in their cigar. Steve Saka had a brainstorm and decided to try something new. And to help him, he solicited Jeremy Reeves, who is the head blender of the famed pipe tobacco maker Cornell and Diehl, I believe is how you say it. And they got together and came up with these cigars. Now, first of all the cigars are 6x52 and come in 13 count boxes. They all look very similar, if not identical, except for one thing: the band at the foot. And the band at the foot designates the type of cigar. I'm going to be reviewing them in the order on the Dunbarton site. I decided just to go in their order. The aromatic number 1 will be first, the English number 27 second, the Bayou number 32 third, and the Navy number 1056 will be fourth. Now, this is a quasi-blind review. By that, I mean, I see the cigars. I know what they are, so it's not a totally blind review, but each cigar that I smoke will be the first one I've ever had. Now, let me give you a little background. Some cigar companies send out press packets on their new releases. Dunbarton Tobacco and Trust did that, and they have several new releases that I'll be getting to, all just one single cigar they sent. So I decided to review these cigars on the spot, live, if you will, never having had one previously. So that's how it's going to work. Today's selection is the Aromatic number 1. And we're going to get to it shortly. There's the density. Has a good feel in the hand. Now, I have to admit to you, I know very little about pipe tobacco. This, according to their website, uses Black Cavendish, Golden Virginia, and Burley pipe tobaccos. Now, it's all mixed in with a Nicaraguan puro, so you have... It's not totally pipe tobacco, because that would, as Steve says, and I agree, would be way too sweet. So he mixes it in, it's blended in with Nicaraguan tobacco. So that is the long and the short of it. They're going to go sequentially just in that order I gave you. But today is the Aromatic number 1. All right, let's see here. Little band. Where are you? There it is. That came off easy enough. We'll make notes as we go in case things change. I don't know what to expect. I've read no reviews. I know nothing about this cigar other than what I've told you. So... Oh, the draw is good, and immediately, I can't tell you what it is, but this sweet flavors come across. Yeah. As the cold draw is sweet. Not anything really discernible, it's just a sweetness. Okay, we're definitely in a different dimension here. Very different. Not bad, different, just different. chocolate mousse, marshmallow cream, brown sugar, light black coffee, black pepper at about 7 to 7.5. And there is a little nutmeg in there right before the black coffee base. That is what you have. And you know what? The basic aroma of the smoke is a little bit of that chocolate mousse. Think the flavor of chocolate mousse with a little marshmallow cream. That's your predominant flavors at the light up. I don't think I've ever used those terms together, but that's what it is. So let's see what we have by the first third. Well, here at the first third, things have changed a little bit. Still have that chocolate mousse, not so much the marshmallow cream. There seems to be cedar in there, a touch of brown sugar, an oily, somewhat bitter nutmeg, some dry cocoa, and a black coffee at the base. The finish is black coffee and average lingering black pepper. Finish is really odd compared to the front end flavors. Cigar is very different. It's in some ways it's a good different. In some ways it's like, I don't know, you know. I'm starting off at 89 because I'm not sure which way it's going, and it's sort of on the line with me. It is actually one tick below the line, but it's close. It's, in other words, it's close. And medium bodied, I guess. Forgot about that. But the cigar could easily go either way, and I'm going to let it, because I don't know where it's going. I honestly don't. So I'm going to let it play out, and let's see what we have in the second third. End of the second third. And this has turned out to be a little bit of fun. You just sit back and literally let the cigar happen. What's happening now is it's gotten really dark and earthy and a little bitter. So it's not going in a positive direction. Unsweetened dark chocolate. Just the hint of cedar and a lot of black coffee with some earthiness. And I'm not even sure there's a little bit of leather attached to that black coffee too. So it's gotten very dark. Very dark. And the sweetness that it started with is not there. There's nothing wrong with a dark noted cigar, but it'd be nice to have some sweetness. But it's moved far away from what it started. Still optimistic, but rating this second third, I would say it's 85. That'd be about the best I could go. It's just not, you know, that's not terrible, but it's not that good. So it's in that category, but it's not that good right now. And this is the first sample, so there's three more to go. Don't get ahead of me. We got to see what the other three are like. And I'm going to approach them just like this one. Just let it happen. Finish is still black coffee. I can't get anything else. And pretty good lingering black pepper. Medium to full. So the second third didn't do it any. J- justice as far as moving up. It definitely moved down. It's just not something that's appealing right now. But let's just see how it plays out. The middle section is always the moving section. If there's going to be a big move, it's going to happen now. Let's see if it bounces back. To the end, so let's wrap it up. Made a little bounce back. Good, I'm glad of that. You know those marshmallow cream notes way back at the beginning? There are the little hints of them now. There's a little brown sugar. Black coffee is still there. For the first time in the cigar, there are cedar citrus notes with brown sugar. This late in the game, medium to full, finish is nutmeg and black coffee. It's been black coffee only, and now it's nutmeg to it. Good lingering black pepper. Been an interesting cigar. Not really my thing, but it did bounce back here in the final third, and it got, you know, had some sweetness with that cedar citrus and brown sugar. The other notes didn't have, but the ghost of the marshmallow cream came back, and it's just a little. It's just a little, but I'm detecting it in there right after that cedar citrus and brown sugar. Then I got that, and then the black coffee. 87 for the final third. It's not that bad. It improved, and coincidentally, that is your overall score, 87. You know, this is a different cigar, and it's not hitting on my cylinders, but, you know, maybe you'll like it. But I've described it to the best of my ability, having never had this cigar before. So there you have it. The Stillwell Star Aromatic No. 1, 87.